Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be checking out EndeavourOS Galileo, which just released yesterday. So I'm just going to type in EndeavourOS, and it's the first link here, EndeavourOS.com. If you scroll to the bottom, they've got North America listed. And then US GigaNet, you just click download there. I've already got the ISO, so I'm not going to click it again. But basically click that and let it download. Okay, now that you've got that, we'll go ahead and go download Etcher, which puts the ISO on our USB stick for us. And it's etcher.belina.io. Download, and it'll scroll down automatically. And we want the 64-bit app image. And that was pretty quick, so we'll just open the downloads folder, right click on the app image, go to properties, and then go over to permissions and allow execution of the program. And then we can just double click on that. And from there, you're just gonna click on this flash from file. You'll highlight the ISO we downloaded, and then you'll select your USB stick, click flash, and it'll prompt you for your sudo password. Just type that in and then let that complete. And I did forget to mention, when Etcher is finished, leave the USB stick in your computer and restart it, and then you'll press F11 or F12. Check your motherboard book to see what key on your keyboard gives you your boot menu. It might also be on the startup screen when your computer first posts when you turn it on. It may say it there as well. But once you do that and you boot to the USB stick, you're presented with this install menu. So I've got an AMD card, so I'm going to select this first one. But if you've got an NVIDIA card, they've got a special line for you to go into and then a fallback. I'm guessing if neither one of these two worked, then you'd go into the fallback and see if that worked for you. But we'll go with the default. And one thing you may notice right off the bat, if you've used EndeavourOS before, typically the installer uses XFCE, and it looks like that's been replaced with Plasma. So we'll just start the installer. We'll go online. English. So we'll just go through all the desktop environments real quick. We've got Plasma, got GNOME, XFCE. That's what the installer used to be based on. Cinnamon, that's like Linux Mint. Mate, that's like GNOME 2. Budgie, LXQT, LXDE. And then our tile manager. We'll go with Plasma. And we'll accept the defaults. And we'll go with Grub. Erase the disk, sure, next. And I'll speed this portion of the video up. All right, now we're going to do our first login. And we're prompted with this welcome app. So we'll go ahead and do a update system. Type your password. There's nothing to do. That's the one cool thing about these rolling releases. When you install it, it pretty much grabs everything new off the internet as it's installing. So once you're logged in for the first time, there's really no update to get. So that's great. So we'll just take a look in here. It's got their website. That's the task that we just did. Let's change the wallpaper. This is a little too busy for me. Yeah, we have to just go with the mountain. Okay. Yeah, that was too much on my eyes. So if we come over here to Assistant, Browse Arch Packages, then we can just search what we're looking for. See if they've got the Brave browser. Okay, I'm not seeing it, so let's just type in Brave browser. We'll see if Brave has any documentation on how to get it installed in Linux. Manjaro, they do. Oh, here's Arch. The Arch packages are available as Brave Bin, Beta, or Nightly. So let's use the bin and press enter. Packages, clean build, I for install, N for none. And it's just building it out now. Yes, to install. So there it went and downloaded the package, built it, and then we installed it. And it looks like there is an icon for us to launch the Brave browser as well. And we'll skip Firefox import and then uncheck both the telemetry. And then go into settings, appearance, and we can switch from light to dark. And we'll take a look at NeoFetch. If you don't already have NeoFetch installed, it's just yay space dash capital S space NeoFetch to get it installed. And then NeoFetch to run it. And we are on kernel 6.6. So that's going to be the new standard. That's going to be the LTS version of the Linux kernel going forward. And we have 919 Pac-Man packages. And we're on desktop environment Plasma 5.27.9. And sitting here idle, we're about 1.3 gigs on memory. So all I've done is I've opened this welcome application that comes with Endeavour. And I've gone to Browse Arch and Browse AUR. And I've searched for Steam on this first tab, which is the official. And then I've opened up the AUR and I've searched for Proton. So what we'll do is we'll go into the terminal. And since this is the official, we'll use sudo pacman s steam. Put in our password. And then yes. And you can see the little Pac-Mans as it's installing. So yeah, as you notice, this distribution is based off of Arch. Everything's done in the terminal. So now if we go to games, there's Steam. So we'll launch it. And let it build. And in the meantime, so for proton up, we're going to use yay. And then we'll do proton up dash QT. Okay, so as you saw, there's lots of dependencies to get proton up QT going. So one thing you might notice when you click on start, there's no discover app. And you're not just missing it, it's not there, right? So I would say this distribution is definitely for a more advanced user. You kind of need to know the terminal. So you'll go to the Arch website, you'll look through the packages or the AUR. So Pac-Man for Arch, and then for the AUR, you'd use yay, and then you just pretty much bring up your terminal, and then after you've found your package, that's when you type in yay, and then whatever package name, right? And then we'll bring up another one. And if you're on the Arch repository, then it's Pac-Man, and you need sudo with that. Pac-Man S, and then package name. And that's to get packages installed. And let's take a look at HTOP. Not found. Let's see if we can get it from yay. Yep, it's there. HTOP. Okay, so we're sitting at right at a gig idle. And we'll check out system settings. If we scroll to the bottom here, about this system, it's KDE Plasma version 5.27.9. And we're on kernel 6.6.2. And that's going to do it for EndeavourOS Galileo. I hope you found the video today informative and helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.